Right, please introduce yourself and what you do.
Hi, my name is Andrew Davies. I'm one of the co-founders of Ideo, which is a conversation marketing platform, so a technology company that works with major consumer brands, helping them to talk on an individual basis with their millions of customers across digital channels.
And so what's your, personally, your main objective for using social media?
Personally, social media is just another way to talk. It's another way to communicate with friends, with associates, with business colleagues. I have, you know, given my role in the company, in business development and marketing, clearly I have a business role there of communicating with potential prospects or clients or partners. But beyond that, you know, I use it to talk to my friends, to stay informed about the news, a whole range of different things.
Yeah. So what's your kind of routine in terms of, you know, using it? Talk us through your sort of general day of when you, how you use it.
Okay, so let's look at the different platforms. So Twitter, I have all my DMs and out messages sent to my phone as an SMS.
Right.
So that's just interrupts my day whenever they come through. That's, you know, just part of my normal communication experience, whatever time of day or night. During the day, I also use TweetDeck as well as the Twitter app on the iPhone just to see what people are talking about. I have several saved searches for industry terms or things I'm interested in or groups I belong to. LinkedIn, I generally use as a search tool to find people that I want to work with, clients or partners, and also for recruiting. So that's really something I go to when I have a specific need.
And you're using the email function there? And
sure, yeah. So I use the messaging system. Yeah. We've all got pro accounts at LinkedIn, at Ideo, so we can email anyone we want to. We use the advertising on there too. I use LinkedIn for the news side as well. You know, they send a good email update every day, I think, with the latest news from my friends. But often I find I've already seen that news through my RSS reader or through Twitter by the time LinkedIn sent it to me.
And so when you're during your day, you're just dipping in and out of it. You know, you're sort of quite rigid about, you know, when you've got a meeting, you know, how you sort of mixing up your time kind of thing.
Yeah, I dip in and out of it.
Yeah.
Twitter particularly, I have a browser extension in my Chrome browser, which alerts me anytime anyone talks about something that's interesting to me or messages me, so that's just there the whole time in the background.
Right.
I think one of the terms people use is ambient social networks. It's this aspect, you have ambient conversations happening in the background to whatever you're doing.
And also, you're quite happy with having that whilst you're trying to concentrate on something else.
Yeah, I turn it off when I've got some serious writing to do, particularly. But most of my day I find that perfectly acceptable. And then, as I said, LinkedIn is often more of a tool that I'll sit down with for an hour to do a certain number of searches and stuff as well, rather than just the general conversation. And then Facebook, from a personal aspect, just continuous conversations with friends and people I, you know, used to live with or used to be at university with.
And so what's your device strategy? Is it sort of, you know, what are you using? BlackBerry, iPhones?
So I have an iPhone. Yeah. Majority of it goes through the iPhone. I use the LinkedIn app, the Facebook app, and the Twitter app, all on my iPhone. And that's great because it should happen anywhere. So those trips on the bus or on the tube suddenly become actually useful.
Yeah.
But obviously on my laptop, I've got all those, you know, there as in my browser.
An iPad, do you use that?
Haven't got an iPad, so I'm not using it through that.
Got that one. Yeah. So, and you sort of said how much work you do on the move. So what exactly? So if you're on the tube, you can't get a signal. What are you doing with that application there?
Often I'm finding that I can look through old messages or on LinkedIn. I have a lot of messages that aren't run through email anymore. They're run through LinkedIn, and so I've got my inbox there that I can search through and find people through. Our CRM as a company is on mobile as well, which has social information in it as well as what we're doing with those people. So I can look through. So after a meeting, I'd sit on the tube and update it from my mobile app. But yeah, you're right, a lot of those social tools rely on a constant internet connection, so there's not so much of the just general chatting when on the tube.
And in terms of blog strategy, you know, what's your strategy for blogging? Are you blogging, or are you just, you know, micro-blogging, or, you know, what would you say your strategy is there?
So I'm not sure it's wrapped up as succinct as a strategy, but personally, I update Facebook and Twitter on a personal level with friends, and that's just about staying in contact with people, telling them about interesting things, having a rant when needed, sharing interesting news. From a business perspective, I blog as well as micro-blogging.
How often do you blog? Do you sort of consciously try and do it once a week or month? Or, you
know? I consciously try and do it twice a week, but it only happens once a week.
Right.
I started off the company blog 2 or 3 years ago. and it's been got some background noise here, and it's been instrumental in building credibility as a business. And so I see the volume of posts running through that as absolutely paramount to that blog continuing in its importance. So it's not just about writing about anything, but it's writing regularly. I try and make sure that myself or one of my colleagues is writing at least 3 times a week on our company blog.
Cool. So overall, what would you say, you know, that digital and social media has had an impact on, you know, what sort of impact does it have on you, your business life generally? How would you sum that up?
I mean, it's given me access that I'd never have otherwise.
Yeah.
So one of the things about social media is that you carry your identity on your sleeve. So anyone could look at my LinkedIn profile or my Twitter account or my Facebook account and immediately understand about me. And therefore, when I go and set up a meeting, there's a context there that means I get much better meetings and quicker meetings than I would if I was just a name or an email address. Conversely, I know much more about the people I'm reaching out to. And so I've many times have booked meetings with very senior people at potential clients or partners who I'd never have been able to have get access to because I can look at their history, look at the things they're interested in, and actually tailor a message to them, an email to them, or a tweet to them that's totally in line with their interests and their understandings.
So when you went to Silicon Valley recently, did you just sort of used social networking to set everything up, did you?
Completely, yeah.
Yeah.
So first thing, search on LinkedIn, anyone I know within that area. Secondly, anyone on Twitter within that area, geo searches for both. And that booked up a whole range of different meetings, and then it's about getting recommendations through LinkedIn to other people, or through Twitter to other people. So yeah, everything. You know, it's the same in London, but yeah, Silicon Valley was a nice new example of that. And I just, it's something that that just gives so much more context to the initial conversation. So you then meet up with somebody, and there's no need to do the small talk. You already know about each other's lives. You've already talked to each other several times online already, and the initial conversation can go so much deeper.
Cool. So what's your top tip for people going social, trying to, you know, having listened to you, what would be, you know, people trying to get into social media, what would be your tip for them? Several tips.
I think it's just about being real. I mean, and part of being real is about having a normal conversation. Many people come with these Twitter strategies and they want to set up a calendar of things they want to talk to people about, but it's so contrived. And so listening first is always the best way. You know, I very rarely initiate any conversation through social media channels without actually understanding who that person is or what they're talking about. So it's working out how to listen effectively across these channels, how to use even older tools like Google Alerts or search technology across Facebook, Twitter, and LinkedIn to understand when people are talking about something that I'm interested in talking to them about, or when I have a specific person, understanding what their conversation has been that day, where they are, what they're talking about, what they like doing. So it sets that context and that background. So yeah, listen first and then talk.
Andrew, thank you very much.
Pleasure.